Siphon, what is wrong? Where is Sam Adams?
Who cares? I've been robbed!
Ils vont me le payer, ces scélérats de merde!
Where are you going?
To get back what's rightfully mine.
Oh! Regardez! Some pathetic redcoats waiting for a beating! I will match your face to your jacket, crapule!
Ces coquins me prennent mon père au Canada, et voilà qu'ils me ravissent ma propriété ici. Il suffit.
English. We are not the king's men. We are free. But the king sends these redcoats to push us around. They are not our masters. This is our city. Let's show them who owns it. It's time to fight.
Stefan, please. Stop and listen to me.
I've listened for long enough. They come into my home and take my things. I will get my revenge. The man responsible for this will pay. His friends will pay. Voilà trop longtemps que je subis ces affronts. Ils vont goûter de mon courroux.
You looking for a fight, Englishman? I'll give you what you...
Ils m'obligent à fuir mon pays, et les voici qui veulent s'approprier ma nouvelle demeure.
There is a way to fight injustice, but this is not it.
Freud? You stupid mackerel! I suppose you want me to tell Johnson his tea just spontaneously combusted? Nonsense! Someone's responsible for this, and you will find out who. And if you can't, I'll gut you and find a smarter mongrel who can.
What do we do? Create a window.
Bloody hell are you?
Why?
You have no right to rob people blind. By decree of the British Parliament or not.
British Parliament? I worked for William Johnson.
Johnson?
And he's suffering cleanly.
Please.
The people seem to have an ear for you. What are the things you lost?
The people listened to me only because I spoke the truth loud enough, which is worth 1,000 times the content of my footlocker. The English, they can keep my things.
You did well tonight.
I said I'd buy you an ale when you first helped me. In place of drink, I offer you my allegiance, for what it's worth.
Your aid is welcome, and I am grateful. Now, I need to find Sam Adams.
Send the free ship back, cargo and all.
Aye, but Governor Hutchison refuses to let them leave. Wants us to take the tea.
What happens now?
We wait for the signal.
What signal?
This meeting can do nothing further to save the country.
That one.
Evening, gentlemen. Shall we be off?
No.
What's the matter?
I have spent today drawn from one bit of madness to another with nothing to show for it. Before I go any further, I would like to know exactly what it is you intend.
Of course. First, we make our way to Nathaniel Bradley's house to fetch the rest of our little group. Then it's on to Griffin's Wharf, where we board the ships and dump the tea. Simple as that.
Simple seems a bit charitable.
Cheer up, Connor. For tonight, we are all victors. The Sons of Liberty get to send a message to England, and you rob William Johnson of his financing. Your village will be saved.
I've an idea. Why don't you lead the way? That should keep us out of any further trouble. Am I right?
Damn it, more guards.
We need to turn the crowd's anger to our advantage.
Say the word, Connor, and I will make it so. We need to keep those bastards at bay while the tea's being dumped.
Let me help. I'm yours to command.
Connor? We saved the last one for you. Best we get out of here, huh? It is done.
Johnson is dead?
No. He retreated when we destroyed the tea.
Only to hatch some new scheme, I'm sure. You should have killed him.
There was no need.
Time will tell if you speak the truth.
Radun Hagedum! Radun Hagedum!
Ganondokon, why are you here? Has something happened?
William Johnson has returned with all the money required to buy our land. He meets with the elders as we speak. I have begged him to resist, but I fear he shall have his way unless you intervene.
How is this possible? We destroyed the tea.
The Templars are nothing if not resourceful. You should have heeded my warning.
Please, you have to stop him.
Of course. Can you tell me where they're meeting?
Izzy not gonna darad it canusa de ne Johnson's you jot the rooks taught. Guahi ganzi watnega nun haradun hagedum.
Ta guader harat guah ganto.
are those who would betray and manipulate you. The worst yet, take the land by force.
We are all too aware of the expedition to a piece of them.
What do you mean, might? We are all one. We should act this way.
How? By standing on our own feet, and if you are trying to do it, you may have a point. More hope.
Peace! Peace! Have I not always been an advocate? Have I not always sought to protect you from harm?
If you wish to protect us, then give us arms, muskets and horses that we might defend ourselves.
War is not the answer.
We remember, Stanwix. We remember you moved the borders. Even today your men dig up the land, showing no regard for those who live upon it. Your words are honeyed, but false. We are not here to negotiate, nor to sell. We are here to tell you and yours to leave these lands.
So be it. I offered you an olive branch, and you knocked it from my hand. Perhaps you'll respond better to the sword.
Are you threatening us?
Yes.
Ah! Thought you might send one of your own to oppose me? Unwise decision. Now,
oh no. What have you done?
Ensured an end to your schemes. You sought to claim these lands for the Templars.
Aye. That we might protect them. Do you think that good King George lies awake at night, hoping that no harm comes to his native subjects? Or that the people of the city care one whit about them? Oh, sure. The colonists are happy to trade when they need food or shelter, or a bit of extra padding for their armies. But when the walls of the city constrict, when there's crops that need soil, when there's no more enemy to fight, we'll see how kind the people are then.
The colonists have no quarrel with the Iroquois.
Not yet, but they will. 'Tis the way of the world. In time, they'll turn. I could have stopped it. I could have saved you all.
You speak of salvation, but you were killing them.
Aye, because they would not listen. And so, it seems, neither will you.
Ayawas ne yahte hagum sare, am dahyayum ne skanas is agum hajah.